Hey guys, as you probably heard, Rammstein has announced another European tour for 2024.
Let's go!
Yeah, Christmas really came early this year.
Couple of months early, yeah.
Yeah. Well, it was long overdue. We were starving since...
Exactly. I was expecting it in September.
Yeah.
Early September. Yeah. So it's more than a month now. I was actually starting to panic a little bit. Like, what am I going to do with my life if there is no another Rammstein tour? No, yeah. Seriously, I was like, what do I do?
The whole year of nothing.
Entire year of nothingness. It's like...
And they went radio silent. And Richard stopped posting his...
On Sundays.
His photos.
Weekly. Yeah.
His weekly Instagram posts.
And one of the last ones was like... He was sitting...
The art of waiting, something like that.
He was sitting
like
on a bench somewhere in like a...
On the couch.
Sweat on a couch in a sweatpants.
Red cap.
And a red cap,
and
of course.
Adidas.
Adidas left and right. And the captain was just like, the art of waiting. Really, man? Like, really?
Yep.
Yeah. They're ridiculous. Anyways, I'm hyped. Like, when I saw the video... You know, the first one that I popped, it was like, let's go!
Yeah, I was in the state of shock and disbelief.
Yeah, you saw it before me.
Yeah.
And you didn't want to tell me anything because you were like...
I was processing. I was like, this is some...
Exactly. Exactly.
This isn't real.
Yeah. And
I wanted to be real, but because I wanted to match, this probably isn't real.
Yeah,
although it says
exactly,
Rammstein
exactly.
Official and everything.
You can't really know, right?
You never know.
Exactly. So what we're gonna try and do today is we're gonna take a look at those videos that made.
We're gonna do a deep dive.
Yeah, a deep dive into the videos.
Yeah.
And they're quite short, but I
totally guesstimate the set list.
Set list and what... Also, I guess a few things that are going to happen with this tour.
Yeah.
Okay. So, maybe we should start with the first video, right?
Yeah, let's do this.
Let's go. All right.
Yeah, we can stop right away.
Yeah, definitely. It's like we have 5 seconds and a bunch of things actually happened.
Yeah, first... Mainland.
Oh yeah.
In the background.
And we actually never heard that one live, right? No one.
I think it was supposed to be played once.
Really?
Yeah, I think I read it somewhere, in some rehearsal or something. Or.
Oh, they actually played it in a rehearsal.
In the reversal.
Reversal. That's a good one. That's gonna sting for a while.
From their satanic.
Satanic.
Satanic era.
Yeah. Okay.
Mainland in the reversal.
Mainland in the reversal.
I think it happened once, but I am not sure. I think I read it somewhere but they scraped it. I don't know. If someone knows or if someone heard it live, educate us.
Yeah, definitely.
We weren't that lucky.
Unfortunately
but
not.
Yeah, there are no records of it live, or at least I haven't found.
Not that I found. And we do dig quite a bit.
Yeah, we try.
We do our best. So,
Mainland.
Do you think it's going to be played live?
Probably not, but...
Oh, please don't.
I'm hoping it will, because that's what opened this announcement. So, keeping our fingers crossed to hear Mainland.
I'm going to super glue them together and keep them crossed. It's really...
Yeah, but it's like that for every song. They're
Vast majority of songs. Yeah, definitely.
I want to hear them all. I want to hear the ones that they're playing all the time. I can't skip them.
Yeah, I mean,
I want to hear all the other ones.
When you say all the other ones.
Yeah, all the other ones. Like, they should make two concerts like Metallica.
Oh, dear God, they'll be ungodly good.
Yeah. Or but eight. For each album.
Yeah, for each album. Those shows would be short, but effective.
Well,
I mean, imagine the entirety of...
We've lived through that.
We would, yeah. We lived through something similar.
Yeah,
you
we
and
already
I.
have.
But it was a bit longer than that. I mean... It was
an hour and a half.
Hour and a half, some hour and 20 minutes, something like that.
But
the tempo was like...
We were dead in the first
15
minutes.
And we were actually in quite good shape back then. It was...
Yeah.
What was
it was 2013? 10 years ago.
10 years ago, yeah. I mean, take 10 years of sitting away. Mm-hmm. We both do desk jobs. But the thing is, it was like no pauses, nothing. Just tempo.
Wir halten das Tempo. That was the name of the tour.
Was it official name or an unofficial nickname of the tour?
No, it was
of the tour leg,
the
huh?
official. That's how they advertised it.
How they did, right? Well, that explains. Wir halten das Tempo is German for we're keeping the tempo. So
really?
not that complicated, right? Keep up. Try keeping up with those guys back then. I mean, seriously, when the last song was Pussy,
was
of course, right?
Attempted mass murder.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. I mean, there were two of us, a few of our friends. I can't remember. It was 10 years ago. But everyone was actually quite young and in good shape.
Yeah.
And, when the last song ended, it was Pussy.
Yeah.
The one that was dropped
the same as
well,
always until this year.
Until this year. Yeah. So when the song ended, no one was like, we want more. We want. Like, none of that was going on. Everyone was just like, thank you and goodbye. Please don't play. I cannot breathe. My lungs are on fire. Like, can I please go home now? Seriously, I mean, like, wow. I don't know. What were your impression of that show?
It was amazing.
Oh, yeah.
There was a serious lack of oxygen, so I have some gaps.
Gaps in memory, right?
Yeah.
And we weren't really drinking, so you cannot...
No.
Like,
pin
it on that.
It was oxygen deprivation.
Definitely. I mean, especially when all the cannons
closed,
fire up and...
Closed...
Yeah, it was in a closed arena.
Yeah.
And then it was like...
But lots of fire and...
Oh, yeah.
It was packed.
The place was packed.
And we were like first, second row.
Well, we didn't have tickets for the fire zone.
But we were lucky.
Extremely lucky. They just saw us jumping in there, let us in. It was
different back then.
Yeah, I suppose.
It was a different dynamic.
Definitely. And it was kind of a...
And we jumped our way to the first row.
Exactly, yeah. That was weird. That was really weird. Now to think of it.
It was the best time of my life.
Best... Yeah, definitely. One of the best places I ever was at. Anyway, so... And we got this out of 5 seconds.
Yeah, this is already...
Good luck for
this is already taking too long.
Yeah,
anyway. So what did we see in the video? We saw mic and...
It's a microphone, yeah.
Stool.
There was a stool.
Drum
was,
stool?
I would say it was Schneider's drum stool.
Yeah.
And it's going through this scanner thing, like on the airport, they have on the airports
so
and on the border crossings.
Schneider and...
Yeah, so I think it would be a good idea to bring Schneider on a tour, right?
I hope they're bringing Till. I mean, someone will sing.
Someone has to sing because there's a microphone.
Yeah.
And to be honest, I don't think they would kind of make it without him. is an important part.
That's topic for another conversation.
All right. Let's not go there. Very well. So we're not replacing Till and we're not replacing Schneider, not on this tour, right?
We're not replacing anyone.
Very well. Very, very well. I like that. So let's start from the beginning, huh?
Yeah.
Let's go. There's the stool and microphone. Oh my, there's a guitar. I would say that was Richard Kruspe guitar. Signature one, the one that was burnt. Is this actually the one that was covered with fire gel?
Dory is so good.
I'm not sure. You think Dory is so good? Is that
they used to in a couple of shows in Paris, for example? They both burnt
in Paris
guitars.
Where we couldn't actually see it on the DVD because there was this guy who over-edited.
let's not go there.
Yeah. So Jonas,
Richard said it all.
Yeah. How did he coin it? I'm maybe too old.
Depends on which interview you watch. He got a headache.
In one interview, he got a headache. In one interview, he was too old. But,
kind of goes together.
It goes in the same direction. I mean, to be honest, it's an impressive, rock movie. I really like it. But it is too much.
Yeah, on its own, each song looks great. But altogether, it's a bit...
Let's put it like this. If you have epilepsy, don't
sensory
please
overload.
Don't watch.
No,
never. I mean, I don't have epilepsy, but I was right next to
this is
season.
How you
like,
get it.
Exactly. I mean, it's one of the ways, definitely. Anyway, this is definitely Richard's
this
guitar.
Is definitely guitar.
it's a guitar, that's for sure. Maybe this is not Richard's guitar. Is it maybe Paul's guitar? I mean...
I think it's Richard, but...
I really can't say, is this Les Paul or is it... Paul is playing Les Paul, right? I'm not making a fool out of myself. Yeah,
no.
Okay. I can't tell. I'm embarrassed a bit. Let's see what else do we have here. Oh.
Hold on.
Yeah. so many things happened in a few seconds.
Yeah, we saw bass, so...
That's Ollie. They're bringing a bassist on the tour.
Someone is going to play the bass.
Hopefully, it's going to be this large guy, that we see. Well, we see, he paints his... I mean,
you see him sometimes.
Once in a while, yeah.
Once in a while, he appears from darkness.
From nowhere. I mean, he paints himself black entirely. And then
sometimes,
just,
not always.
Yeah, but... Yeah, that's also true.
Sometimes he just wears a garbage bag or something.
Yeah. and those crazy,
glasses and
that's a bowl. That's not even you can't call that glasses. It's a bowl that goes over his head.
Ski helmet.
Maybe
half of it. I don't know.
Maybe yeah. Definitely. And then he just pops out of nowhere, rocking out like crazy.
He's lurking
really love
in the shadows.
Oh yeah. And his bass playing is completely underappreciated, to be honest.
Yeah.
I mean, because he's really good at what he's doing.
Yeah, well, they all are.
Definitely. One of the most complete bands ever. And what we hear, what we see here
we
on the monitor.
We saw keyboard also. So.
Oh yeah, those also. So they're bringing the small guy, right?
Who exactly is the small guy?
Yeah, the small guy with the keyboard,
He's not
looks,
small.
He's not small, he's a monster, but
he's
compared to the rest of the guys.
192, he's...
Almost 2 meters tall, right?
Yeah.
But that's the weird thing with him. We're talking about the keyboard player.
He's the same size as Schneider.
That's so weird. Because I guess it's because he's so thin compared to them. And I'm saying this compared to them because we saw these people quite
Yeah, there close. Is no one small there.
Exactly. I mean, even Flake, who looks thin compared to the other guys, we saw him in this one interview with some Canadian guy, if I'm not mistaken. I mean, the awkward one when he where he just
I
like
don't
abruptly ended.
Remember.
It was that one where
yeah, and but I don't remember.
You don't remember what he looked like in there.
Yeah.
Well, he actually looked quite large compared to the guy that was interviewing him. You know, his arms and everything. And then you put him back in this context with the rest of the Rammstein guys, and he's like, he looks. I don't know how to explain it. Small compared to them, because I guess. They're monsters.
Well, I'd say that was more of the case in the beginning. They're more even now. I think gained some.
You think Flaky gained some weight?
Yeah, they're
but
equalizing.
I suppose so. He can't stay that thin forever.
Oh, he can, but.
But if Richard's making donuts, then. Okay, so shall we continue with the video?
We saw something more interesting.
Yeah? What?
The bow.
Oh, the bow! Yeah. Let's. Keyboard, bass, and the bow. Look at it. Look at the beautiful thing. So we know we're gonna get. What's the song again? Don't look at me like that. I can't remember the name. If you shot me now,
of their
I'm
most
the
famous
pressure.
Song,
exactly.
And it's not Du hast.
I'm feeling the pressure now. Is it
Dur ist so gut?
Yeah, Dur ist so gut. Why was it so hard for me to remember the name?
I don't know.
It's the pressure, I guess. Let's see what it looks like. Look at it. Look at the beauty.
So what do you think this is?
At first, I was thinking of a suicide vest for the Sturm, but apparently this is the sleeve, you know, the firework sleeve that Richard and Paul put on.
Yeah, probably, most likely.
I mean, it looks like that to me, to be honest. We did see it. Well, we never saw it this close up, but this looks like that. So,
we're still on Dur ist so gut.
Yeah, definitely.
With the possibility, small possibility of Der Sturm.
Oh, they'll be so awesome! I never actually heard that song live.
No, me neither.
But I would really love to hear it. It's actually a really good song.
Yeah, they all are.
Yeah, I mean that's. Kind of
you can probably guess that we really love Rammstein.
We are fans, like
we're huge fans. Okay, so let's go further.
I freaked out so hard when I saw this
and
the first time.
This was the best part. This was the best part for me.
Me too.
Is this going to be Angel? In its original form and beauty.
I mean, I really like the a cappella thing. It's really cool.
Yeah,
and
it's beautiful, but I wanna hear.
Yeah,
I wanna hear the riff.
I actually heard the riff. Heard the original version in 2010, when I saw them for the first time.
Yeah, I missed that.
And I saw Till. Like with the wings spread out and the fire shooting out of them and everything, but I really miss it. I mean,
I've never seen that live in all the concerts, and I've been to 10 of them already, but I missed all of the all of the concerts where they played Engel
and
in the original.
Yeah, and I had 11 concerts.
And that's that one.
That's the one where I saw Angel, actually. But the thing is, I don't know how this is going to work with the current stage setup. But to be honest, I don't care. I want to see it. I want to hear it.
Yeah, I want to hear it.
I don't even need the wings.
No.
I mean, he's an old guy. he's in good shape, but he's an old guy. If he doesn't want to carry these huge metallic wings, he doesn't have to. I just want to hear this epic riff, you know. And
for all I care, they can go out in their Adidas tracksuits.
Yeah, you would want to see that, wouldn't you? Huh?
Yeah, it would be epic.
Eastern Europe talking here.
Eastern European core.
Exactly, yeah. So
hits hard.
Yeah, but imagine how epic that would be.
Yeah.
If they were actually to show up in like Adidas tracksuits.
At least for a rehearsal. Like
whatever. Yeah, but if we were to see them in, I mean, it's like I have a feeling like that's natural environment for most of them, except for Paul. He's like posh.
Yeah,
he's so posh. Like and he's into fashion and stuff, you can see,
and it. Birkenstock.
That's weird. But I think it's a German thing, because yeah. I saw a bunch of Germans just like white socks and Birkenstocks running around.
Yeah, well,
Italy, like.
he is barefoot in Birkenstocks, and then completely elegant.
Yeah, and he
from
has
the feet up.
He has a hat,
little hat, and
then like there's this awesome black jacket usually, and pants
or white,
like, or white. Sometimes it's white. You're right, and then Birkenstocks. Really, like mm-hmm. I mean, it's kind of cool and kind of cringy.
It's a statement.
Definitely, definitely. I guess it's a German thing. Anyway, these wings. I'm like so hyped that I'm seeing these wings here.
Yeah.
So if Engel is on the
set, I pray for Engel.
Oh man, I would go completely insane.
OG.
I would go completely, completely insane.
It's like one of my first favorite songs of Rammstein.
I think I heard it before Du Hast. I'm not 100% sure.
I haven't. I think
maybe I'm
pretty sure that Du Hast was the first thing I heard from them.
Yeah, yeah. I think the first thing I heard from them was Feuer frei. And I actually saw it in a movie.
You were late.
Yeah, yeah, I'm a late bloomer. Anyway, I saw it in a movie. And I was like, there's no way in hell that this band in a movie, that this is like a real thing.
That they really exist.
Yeah, that they really exist.
I wish Rammstein were real.
Yeah, like, there's no way in hell that these guys are like, this is the thing, you know, they exist. Like, this, I was thinking, yeah, like, this is...
It would be so cool if they were real.
Exactly. The fool I was, I didn't know, you know? And then... when I find out, like, wow, but there's no fucking way they're doing this fire and everything. And then I realize, okay, they're doing fire masks and yep. And so much more. So it was like, wow.
Mind blown.
Exactly. Like, poof. Anyway, I'm... Well, this wings here bring me that kind of feeling again, like I'm a boy again, and like, oh my god, I want to see it.
Yeah, I really, really want to see it.
Let's see what else is hidden
mm-hmm.
in this video. Oh, what does this look like to you?
Like a flamethrower?
Seriously. Really? Like a flamethrower? Of course it's a flamethrower. This is a Rammstein video.
I don't know. What
but
did you want to hear?
Well, when I saw this, I heard a melody in my head and I couldn't remember what was the melody. And then I realized what was the melody. And oh dear God, I really hope this is the melody they're going to play. I'm talking about, you know what I'm...
Der Meister.
Exactly. I mean, this looks hell of a lot like a flamethrower that Till uses on, what was it, Bizarre Festival 1997.
Yeah.
And like shooting flamethrowers over people.
I don't know, we could revisit that video and compare from probably, the back of my mind, yeah, it kind of
probably should do
it
that.
It kind of looks like that, but like I'm always afraid it's just visual thinking. I always like try to
I would try and have them open with their Meister.
Yeah, but I'm like wishing for that song to be back on the set list. Like for the last year, I'm like, they need to open with their Meister on the next tour. Don't ask me why. They need to open with their Meister, and the next song should be Usher.
So yeah, Usher. I mean, definitely. And then
that's flash. That's what I'm like secretly hoping for, secretly wanting.
The perfect opening of a show, right?
And if someone from Rammstein management, or I don't know, Richard,
maybe
listens,
I think the Schneider,
please
is the
consider
blocker.
This. Consider this.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, but I think the Schneider, he is the biggest blocker of things there. Like, he doesn't want to do things, and then he want to do things, and you know that's what that's the vibe I pick up from the interviews and things like that. You don't think so, huh?
No, I think he just says that, but then he'll just play.
I mean, we all saw how happy he is while playing Zenzucht.
They're and all very happy when they play the old songs,
the Old
and,
Testament,
and we are all. Oh, very happy, yes, when they are. Play the old songs.
I mean
I've heard
last and Hayrat-e Mih, I was like, oh yes,
this was the best thing ever.
Then I was a bit disappointed when they removed it,
but we got Bestrafe Mich,
and I was like, okay, I can't be angry about this.
No,
this is awesome.
You can't complain, know?
Yeah, but the one thing I can't complain about is day dropping. This might come out a bit controversial, but the fact that they dropped... it's mixed. Tick Tack and Zeig Dich, those two songs for me are like, oh, insanely
but
awesome.
They are both bangers live, and the crowd loved it each time.
Well, at least in the Fire Zone they did.
Well, in Austria, the whole stadium sang.
In Austria,
both.
In Klagenfurt?
I mean, they sang like through the whole concert, to be honest, from beginning to the end. Tick Tack only came out like a month before, and
everyone
knew
every
each
single
word
of it. Like,
yeah, and they all sang.
Insane. What band can have that? What I don't
know. With bands with this kind of history, usually the crowd doesn't want to hear new songs. Like,
yeah, I just want to
skip it. But when's the good part?
But if you read through forums, if you read through, you know, most of the comments online, you would have people, well...
online you can find the haters, but really on site, there are none.
Exactly. Everyone was like, oh, this is awesome, Ron.
Yeah, like it crazy. Was amazing. And even Armageddon.
Oh,
there were haters, like for that opener, there were some haters. But I think now, even like a year after, they love it even more than...
Exactly, I want it back.
Yeah, we all want it back.
I want it back because
it's
so...
It's a perfect opener.
Yeah, I liked Was ich liebe. It was cool. It kind of worked. I mean, it worked. But this one was just perfect opener.
And it's so mighty.
Yeah, it has this like...
It's really...
epic moment when everyone
I
comes
love
together
the song on the album, but live it's even
when
better.
I heard that live, it was crazy. Yeah.
It's got the crazy energy and like.
I mean it's how the show starts. You know, you have this smoke, and then you have Schneider come out, and you know he's posing and having his moment, and then he slams on his drums really hard and everything explodes, and it's so loud that like
you cannot believe
how loud it is and how strong the actual explosion is, and then
you cannot be prepared for it.
Exactly. And then what happens is you just like you make a step back, You have to make a step back. You jump. There are a few people who jump really high.
You jump and pray your phone didn't fall out of your hands that happens.
The first time I was trying to record a little bit, you know, I know it's a dick move, but I mean, come on.
Yeah, just the beginning.
Like, I have this snapshot and, oh man, I really, literally, like, almost dropped my phone in the crowd and was like, what did just happen? It was the shake was genuine. And then, you know, when you're prepared for it, you go to a next show and you think you're prepared for the...
But you're not.
You're not. You jump again.
Every time.
like, we saw it for like four times. And four times. And I jumped every single time.
Yeah.
It was crazy. Anyway, I would really like to see
Der Meister.
Oh man, it would be so awesome. Loved.
But if we're wrong, this is just mental starting kit.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it could be a mental starter kit. Or they're trolling us. Anyway, it looks cool.
I mean, we're getting mental, we know that, but that's unskippable. But Der Meister would be so cool.
As you said,
cool.
So was Firefly.
I think mental is a bit bigger.
It is, to be honest, it is. But again, you never know with these guys. I mean,
well, I would love Firefly back, but
I don't think Firefly works on an open air event. I mean, you can have.
It's not like they haven't done it.
They have, but I mean, we saw those videos where like the flames twist above their heads and
yeah,
everything.
It's dangerous for sure.
And I think it's more dangerous than it. I mean, you have to make, you know, it's a calculated risk, and I guess they calculated it's too risky. I think that's honestly, I think that's the only reason why it's not in the set list. They don't want to do it without the masks.
Yeah.
And
masks are the best thing. I mean, it's
they're
maybe
awesome. Yeah, they're
it's
awesome.
Maybe
it's
my favorite
special effect.
Yeah.
I mean, it because no one is crazy enough to do it. I
yeah.
Genuinely, I don't know if you guys still listening.
It is so cool. Too
yeah,
cool.
It's. I'm like, I was. I told you. I thought it was a fake, you know, movie.
Yeah, movie
thing.
Effect.
Apparently, it but was no. A thing before the movie, and yeah. That's why it ended up in the movie because it was so cool.
Too cool.
Too cool. Yeah, definitely. And
we
now,
saw that live.
Oh, I saw that one live. Exactly. Yeah. Oh man. Yeah. Oh.
So close the arena. No wind.
Yeah, no
that's
wind
so
and anything,
lucky.
But. You know,
no wind, but no air.
Every time, there was some air, but just
oxygen,
no oxygen
deprivation.
In it because, well, of all the fire. Anyway, you know, and when you're in that arena or on the stadium and everything, and, you know, there's this fire thing going on the stage, and you feel the heat and you feel it's really hot.
Yeah, it can be.
But
really, really hot.
Really hot and like...
How are they handling it?
Exactly. I mean, it becomes uncomfortable on like 10, 15 meters away or 20 meters
yeah.
away from the flame.
If it's hot day...
It feels really uncomfortable. And then I'm thinking like there is this crazy guy with this fire peacock backpack on his back.
Yeah.
And it's like...
And
10 centimeters
two other crazy guys.
With this huge ass flamethrowers... strapped on their guitars
while
10
playing.
Meter while playing. I mean, like, and those things tend to be quite hot and actually a little bit of, let's say they're a bit uncomfortable. They are a bit uncomfortable, you know, when you're in the crowd. It's extra cool, don't get me wrong, but it can get a bit uncomfortable.
Depends on the temperature.
Yeah.
And the weather.
If you got wet by the rain.
If it's a cold and wet weather.
You love
then
it.
It's really
you
cozy.
You actually get dry.
Yeah.
That's how we got dry.
More fire, please.
Yeah, if you guys could, you know, turn up a heat just a little bit.
But because if we got it's wet. Like 40 degrees and you were burning in the sun
and
waiting.
There's no air conditioning. There's no air conditioning away from that.
And then, yeah, you feel it almost as much as they do.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I cannot know how it is for them, but that's...
I think it's intense. I think it's really intense. Yeah. But I think it's less intense for them than for a normal person, let's put it like that. No, but they're doing it for 30 years now, and they're kind of used to it. That's weird. I mean, how
and
can
this
get
was
to
supposed
that?
To be a deep dive, but
yeah, we're diving really, really deep.
It turned to some kind of a rant and a trip down the memory lane.
Memory lane.
Yeah, that one.
That lane. Okay. So, so we're into this.
If anybody listens, let's go.
Let's move forward.
What there is.
There's another gun.
This is Duhast.
This is Duhast. I mean, it's kind of obvious that they're gonna do that one.
Yeah.
First of all, it's one of the cooler effects that I have for the show. And
it looks amazing.
It looks so amazing with this. I don't know, is it phosphorus or something that like, who knows?
I wouldn't know.
FFPX or what's the name of the company that
does it?
So they probably do know because it's their thing. But it looks so awesome, you know, and even when you're not in slow motion, it looks cool.
It looks amazing, and Duhast is obviously the biggest hit.
Yeah, it's the greatest song they have.
Yeah.
Well, the biggest hit, not greatest song for me.
No,
but
it's not the greatest
hit.
Song. It's the biggest hit.
Definitely, yeah.
Everyone and their mom knows the song.
Exactly, exactly.
And I mean, literally. And
no, yeah.
Yeah, and when I think about the set lists, like, I always think that I could most easily skip that one. But when you hear it live, it's works.
Like unskippable.
It always works.
Yeah, it's unskippable. Everyone screams their lungs out.
Yeah.
I mean, I would, at this point, I don't know if I would voluntarily play Duhast for myself. But every time I hear it, it rocks out so hard. I just,
yeah.
The thing just works. Maybe we should move forward.
Yeah.
Huh? Okay. Here's the cannon. This is so funny because, I mean, who shoots a cannon at their co-workers for a living? Like, really? I don't know many people that do that.
Not many people are allowed to do that.
And even fewer are that, you know, that are actually not asking for permission. You said they're not allowed, and then I'm saying he's not asking for permission.
Yeah, I'm saying some probably would, but they can't.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, that's what you're talking about. Yeah, well, I mean, that would be actually a good idea. You know, I have a few people
let's
on
go.
My mind. Let's move on. And it goes, man. What do we see? What is she going to see? You know what this is?
No.
This is bankruptcy alert.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like we did in another video. Actually, this is a bankruptcy alert. For a lot of people. Rammstein.com tickets. Yeah.
Because it's, who needs food?
I mean,
it's overrated.
Exactly. I mean, you can eat once in a while, but I would really like
to. You can stare at the sun.
I don't think that works.
Some would disagree.
You think it works, huh?
I don't know. I haven't tried it. No.
I heard of this.
But maybe this is the right moment.
You think we completely start eating? But winter is coming. there's not that much sun now. Oh, you mean like that? Didn't even think of that. Let's not sing. Yeah, maybe you shouldn't do that. Okay, so.
So we have another video.
Yeah, yeah. Let's.
But what do we have? I mean, for the set list with.
Oh yeah.
Let's summarize.
We have Du hast.
Du hast mein Teil. Du riechst so gut.
What was there also? Engel. Please, let's have Engel, guys.
Like, maybe Der Meister.
Oh, that would be so cool.
And another.
No, because of the message.
Thinking
the song
is Zerstören.
Zerstören, Der Meister, they'll be so like.
And Mainland.
I would really like to hear that live. And I would like to hear them do that in Germany. It will be like extremely funny to see the fire that starts afterwards.
Is that before or after Deutschland?
Exactly. They could like make a mix. You know, start out with Mainland.
And sing Deutschland.
Ease into Deutschland. Remix.
Yeah, it's like.
Then like.
Richard's DJ set.
Exactly. And then once Deutschland is done, jump right back into Mainland and like set things.
And what really would, what would be the special effect there? Like the end of the video where they're all Rammstein like, or are they going to jump on the stage in their bathing suits?
I know a lot of people who would actually pay a lot of money to see them in their bathing suits, like, so I think that includes you. I mean,
I'm not complaining.
You know what? I'm not complaining either.
I want to see someone complain.
Yeah. Let's see our next video. No, not this one. Sorry. Give me 1 second. Okay. Mm-hmm. So we have our next video here. Let's roll. Okay. This is one of my favorite songs live.
Yeah, I know.
Radio. I love this song so much. It's so awesome. I mean, I rock out so hard. Maybe I rock out a bit too hard to this one. Okay, let's move on. This looks interesting.
Tinte, schalt auf 6.
Again.
What do we get from this? Okay, there's radio, obviously.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm just gonna go back to this flamethrower here. You're kind of playing really hard on that one.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm really hoping for Der Meister. I mean, we have it in 2 videos and it's like...
Who knows? You can only
hope.
That'd
be so cool. That'd be so cool, man.
That would be the best. And Dasha.
Oh, we need Dasha. We really need that one.
So Dasha.
Staub. So Staub. Oh, okay, I need to hear it
down,
right now.
Calm down.
Okay. Okay, here is another bankruptcy warning. A bit elaborated, actually.
Yeah, this one's worse than the first one.
Yeah, definitely.
Now you see the
now you see the death occasions. Toll. You see the death toll, the carnage that's about to happen to your wallet and your bank account.
So they're starting in Prague?
Yeah.
Like 2 years ago?
Yeah, it's Prague. Oh, yeah, they actually 2 years ago they yeah. started in Prague. Yeah, 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 right, you're right.
In 22 they started in Prague. The same place, the same location.
It was this airport, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember knockoff videos from YouTube. It looked really cool there.
Yeah. And approximately the same time as 2 years ago, I think.
It's also early May, right?
Yeah, mid May, something like that.
And then after Prague, you're going to Dresden.
Yeah, it's really close by. There are currently two shows announced for Dresden. But there are speculations that there might be more.
Also for Prague, too. I mean...
Yeah, well, they can always add another day.
Before and after. I mean, they do have two sets of stages, and this is quite close, so...
Yeah.
Also, after... Dresden, there's Belgrade. We're looking forward to that one too.
Yeah, we're definitely checking that out.
It's, let's say it's local for us.
It's close to home.
Quite close, yeah. And there, that's May 24th, and there they have only one
concert show planned, announced. So, well, and the announced, next one right. is
after
Athens.
That, that's Athens, yes, and also another one that's May 30th. And then San Sebastian.
Spain.
That looks
Spain
cool.
is...
5th June.
5th of June. Yeah, there are gaps in between those. I mean, they could just use it to spend some time on the Greek,
beach?
Greek coast or Spanish coast.
Or do a few yeah. more shows in between.
Which just do some more shows. We will see.
I mean, they did do that. On previous tours, actually, announce more dates and
yeah, especially they announce some dates and after Leafed pre-sale, then when the official sale starts, they announce they add a few more. At least that's what they did last year. So
yeah, but that kind of makes sense. I mean,
like
why would you want to
have a few days after the original announcement, there were more dates added.
So. Should we hope for more dates?
And I think we can expect more dates, but
definitely.
Yeah, no one knows for sure.
I suppose why they do it like this is they announce and then start selling tickets.
Well, when they sell out in like 5 minutes, then they announce another one. Yeah.
And when that sells out in
the
10
last
minutes,
year mass was for Belgium. Like
you
keep trying to get tickets and they keep disappearing right in front of your nose and then another concert appears, another date and it is already sold out and then another date appears and it is already sold out.
It's sold out before it was announced.
Yeah.
Like they added another one in panic, I would say.
I don't know.
And added another one and it was 5 minutes later it was on TikTok and on Twitter and like everywhere. I don't think I'm not sure about Twitter, but they were
kind of
dead on
I
Twitter last year, this year. But yeah, and anyway, it's like you go to see if there are tickets and everything is sold out even though like
it wasn't even public
exactly
information, like, yeah.
It's crazy. It's just crazy stuff.
We are Spain? In San Sebastian, yeah.
That's right. And then after Spain, they're going to Marseille.
Or San Sebastian,
yeah. Someone please school me on the Spanish pronunciation and also on the French because Marseille.
That's
going to
be fun.
Yeah. Marseille. How is this pronounced? I mean, and then Barcelona.
Barcelona.
Okay, that's... kind of really want to go there.
Yeah, I was there.
I never been. we have to go. You have, please, would you take me? Maybe.
I'll consider.
Okay. I'll wash the dishes tonight, honey. Don't worry. It's the dishwasher. It does it itself. Lyon after that, France. And then...
They were in Lyon like 2 years ago.
2022?
Yeah. This year it was Paris. And 2022 it was Lyon. And I keep saying 2 years ago because for me now it's 2024. Because we are talking about the 2024 tour. So yeah, this year is actually last year and the last year is 2 years ago. Just accept the fact that Rammstein announced it's 2024 and...
Yeah, but 2020
lasted
for 2 years.
That's how I count my time.
2020 also lasted for two and a half years, so...
Well, let's not go there.
Let's not go there also, okay. I don't know how to pronounce this place in the Netherlands. It's like...
Nijmegen?
What?
Maybe. I'm winging it.
Nijmegen.
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 I don't know.
I would really like...
Improvisation. This is improvisation.
Yeah, I agree. And then Dublin? Oh, we all have to go to Dublin, don't we? But I need a visa for that. I don't like
That's
it.
That's too complicated.
But
we,
I really
we would
like
love
to,
go,
to
go to Dublin, but...
Yeah.
Probably not.
I mean, I would like to see Ireland, but...
Yeah. It's a beautiful country.
But the visa thing is quite complicated. You know, I don't want to deal with that. We have Belgium, Ostend, on 27th of June.
Yeah,
I would kind of want to go to Belgium too. I mean, they have
beer
waffles, and chocolate and waffles and...
Lots of chocolate and beautiful, beautiful country also.
Oh man, that place is... I mean, you know, when you see the photos, it's just... I don't know why I went for the chocolate and beer, like the worst stereotypes, but...
But they're really good. I mean, they're
exactly
the best.
Exactly, they're the best, you know. I don't know if my Swiss friend would, like, agree with me regarding the chocolate, but I guess I would have to do a compare test.
Swiss are great, but I think the Belgian chocolate is the best.
I'm going to tell him tomorrow, and we'll see. He would be a bit upset. And then Copenhagen.
I don't discriminate chocolate. I love chocolate.
Yeah, I mean... I could have chocolate from Belarus. I don't care. I really don't care. we have Copenhagen in Denmark. That's 5th of July. And then 17th of July, Klagenfurt. Also 18th of July, Klagenfurt. It's a lovely little town in Austria.
Österreich. Yeah.
And we were there already.
Yeah, we were there. In 2022 for also two Rammstein concerts.
Imagine that.
What a surprise. That was kind of out of the blue.
Just tickets just kind of appeared, right?
It was like just after the pandemic and...
Everything was lifted.
Yeah, so they released some more tickets just before the concerts and we weren't planning on going, but... I couldn't resist, and I just bought the tickets. And
yeah, I was just telling you to a friend today how weird it was. I mean, I was going to gym, and you stayed at home that night, and you were talking about tickets and something. But I was kind of in a hurry, didn't really listen to you.
No,
which kind of happens sometime. Anyway, when I came back home, you said like, "We're going to Austria," and I was like, "Really? Yeah, that's." For Rammstein, right? Next week. Really? Like, okay. And then I remember my surprise when you said for two shows.
Yep.
I was like, how do you... I mean, like...
If we are traveling to Austria, then...
No, but it wasn't that. It was more like we have this sold-out tour from, like, 2 years that was supposed to happen 2 years ago. And somehow we have tickets for, well, not two, but... Three shows actually, because we already had bought
at
tickets
at the time
for
we had bought tickets for
Göteborg. which is a completely different story.
Yeah, let's I think we
digressed enough, let's say.
Too much.
Yeah, we kind of tend to do that. There is this place in Italy, which is going right after Klagenfurt on 21st of July. It's called, and I'm going to butcher this, Reggio Emilia. Maybe I didn't butcher it.
Reggio Emilia.
Reggio Emilia, huh?
Maybe.
Maybe we didn't butcher it that hard. And it's somewhere in between, what was it, Parma and...
Bologna.
I would say, yeah. And it looks kind of neat. Like, you
everything
know, I mean,
looks great in Italy.
Yeah, that'll be an understatement, I would think.
Yeah, we love Italy.
Definitely, definitely. And I'm thinking, like, I'm going here if possible.
We're going to try.
Do our best. I don't know how to read German, like...
Gleiskirche?
Gleisenkirchen? Kirchen?
Let me see.
Yeah.
Like...
I'm looking at this on my phone, so...
Gelsenkirchen.
Gelsenkirchen. Okay, so I know there was this meme going on on Twitter. Where the hell is Gelsenkirchen for some reason? On Rammstein Twitter. Yeah, like people are kind of insane.
I think this is going
shows.
To be the biggest event in the history of Gelsenkirchen.
Let's say it's going to be
not
kind
that
of
I know the history of that place, but it...
It's a small town.
There are two concerts announced. There's always a possibility for the end of the tour that they might add one or two more.
Yeah, that happens.
Because everyone wants to go to the last concert of the tour.
That's kind of crazy.
It's a phenomenon.
Like, yeah. People like fight.
So there's going to be like 150,000 of visitors there.
In a town of 20,000.
I don't know how big it is. It's not famous. That doesn't mean...
Yeah. That's also a thing. I mean, we know about those people who, for this tour... Like, should we talk about that?
Or maybe leave it for another...
Another one. Yeah, we're going to...
Another rant.
Don't
spend everything in...
We'll try not to spend everything. But we cannot possibly spend everything in one go.
Well, we kind of did a lot.
It's a long video.
It wasn't supposed to be a long video.
No, this was supposed to be like a short 15-minute thing.
Yeah. But we decided to... talk about everything.
Yeah, so
everything Rammstein.
Thank you for listening to us. Everything Rammstein today.
So how are we wrapping this up?
Yeah, I think it's time for us to wrap this up. Well, first of all, thank you for listening.
If anyone listened till the end of this rant,
I would be surprised, to be honest.
Thank you for staying with us.
Huge thanks.
What are your thoughts on the set list? What do you think they're going to play? What do you think they're going to skip?
Yeah.
From the current set list,
exactly,
maybe?
Exactly. I have no idea, honestly.
Well.
I'm scared. I'm a little scared because...
Nobody's safe.
Nothing's safe. Exactly. With these guys,
they're
like,
going to change the opener probably because they changed the opener in each leg of the tour. Should we make another video about the set list instead of this one, which was supposed to be about the set list?
Yeah, we could actually make another video regarding the set list, because this was supposed to be originally speculation about the set list.
And it turned into something different completely.
Trip down memory lane.
The story of how we love Rammstein.
So
the story about...
our love.
We love Rammstein story.
Yeah. And I hope you enjoyed it, I guess.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know.
Okay, so I guess.
Tell us your ideas. What are they going to add? What are they going to skip from the set list? And what are your wishes? What would you love to hear?
What would be your perfect set list?
Yeah.
Please write it down in the comments.
Are you going to the concerts?
And where?
Where?
And where you are not going and you would like to go, also type those.
Yeah, we would all love to go everywhere.
I would like to
go
to Dublin.
I would like to go everywhere. I would go to the whole tour if I could.
Definitely, definitely. But I simply don't have enough vacation days. And the money is a bit of a problem.
Maybe they can employ us. I'll go with them.
That'd be a good idea, yeah. Yeah. I mean, I would...
I can paint Richard's nails.
Look, I would do anything. Oh, well, next to anything. Almost everything. Well, everything.
Pretty much.
Yep. Okay. Maybe we went a bit far on this one. That sounded weird.
Well, anyway, we were just honest. Thank you guys for
listening. Yeah, that's the honesty. The honesty killed.
That's the honesty for you.
The honesty killed the cat, or was it curiosity? I'm not really sure about that.
Anyway, if you are still listening, leave your comments on any of these topics that we touched in this too long video.
Extremely long video.
Yeah. And
which is mostly audio.
Who knows? Maybe we will record something else. Probably we will record something else.
Definitely we will. But tell us, would you like to hear
some other rant?
Definitely, yeah.
About Rammstein, since that's what's going on for another year.
Definitely. And if there's another band you would like us to talk about, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, we were going to go to Metallica, but everything's sold out. We'll see how that goes.
Okay, so thank you for listening. Don't forget to subscribe. I mean, that'll be nice. And
subscribe if you want.
Yeah. And that's it for now.
Yep.
Okay. Bye, guys.
Bye.